हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम इज मुकेश भाई तन्ना। एज वी हैव सीन लेसन नंबर 4, समरी, कैरेक्टर स्केच, हाइलाइट्स एंड क्वेश्चन आंसर। नाउ लेसन नंबर 5, द स्नेक एंड द मिरर। इन दिस पर्टिकुलर लेसन बाय वेकाम मोहम्मद बशीर, वी सी फर्स्ट चैप्टर स्केच। सी ऑन लेफ्ट साइड, दिस इज अ फ्राइटनिंग स्टोरी टोल्ड बाय डॉक्टर टू हिज फ्रेंड इन अ ह्यूमरस वे एंड हैज एन अनयूजुअल एंडिंग। दिस पर्टिकुलर स्टोरी इज द फ्राइटनिंग स्टोरी विच क्रिएट फियर, told by a doctor to his friend in a humorous way and has an unusual ending beyond our expectation. So this is the frightening story told by a doctor to his friends in a humorous story we read and enjoy, which ends unusual. The person telling the story is a young bachelor homeopathic doctor. The person who is telling a story is a young bachelor. Bachelor that you know who has not married alone. Bachelor and homeopathic doctor just starting his practice. The young doctor tells about his encounter with a snake. The doctor told his encounter to meet suddenly with a snake. With a snake in his house and how a mirror helped his escape and immediate death, and how a mirror helped him to escape an immediate death. That is what the story tells. Again, listen carefully. This is a frightening story told by a doctor to his friends in a humorous way and has an unusual ending. The person telling the story is a young bachelor who has not married, homeopathic doctor, just starting his practice. The young doctor tells about his encounter with a snake in his house and how a mirror helped him escape on immediate death. That is the main particular points chapter sketch that we should keep in mind. Now about the character. The doctor, he is a young bachelor, homeopathic doctor, who is conscious of how to look smart. He is a young bachelor, homeopathic doctor, who is conscious about how he looks smart. He escapes uninjured from an encounter with a snake due to his presence of mind. Take the decision, right decision at the right time, that is called presence of mind. So about the character, one character only, the doctor. He is a young bachelor, homeopathic doctor, who is conscious of how to look smart, and he escapes uninjured from an encounter with a snake due to his presence of mind. Take the right decision at the right time. Clear? Now the summary of the chapter. See, summary of the chapter. Doctor sees his face in a mirror. Doctor sees his face in mirror. See, the narrator, who is a doctor, explain his experience with a snake. What type of experience he has, he explained. It was a hot summer night when he used to live in a room in the village. He lived in a village. So hot summer night, and he used to live in a room in the village. When he came to his room, it was about 10 o'clock. When he returned from the village at 10 o'clock at night, the doctor was sitting in a chair in his house at night and wondering how to look more handsome as he watched his face in a mirror. He came home at 10 o'clock at night. Then he was sitting on the chair looking his face in front of the mirror, and he just thought how to look smart in the mirror. He decided how to look handsome. He decided that he would shave daily, keep a thin mustache, and always have a smile on his face. He thought, if he wants to look handsome, then he has to shave daily, means he has to cut his beard, then keep his mustache thin, and always have a smiling smile on face. These are the virtues that they men very handsome. These measures would make him look smarter and more handsome. He heard a noise. There was many rats in the room that constantly made noise. Like this thinking was going on, he heard the noise of the rats, and there were many rats in his house, so he heard that noise of the rats constantly. The particular noise was going on. Snake falls on the doctor. Suddenly a snake fall on doctor's shoulder. Suddenly a snake fell on doctor's shoulder from above. It may have come to the house due to the presence of many rats there. Suddenly a snake fell on doctor's shoulder from above, because there was not particular slab of the house, as you know, and that is why the snake also remained upper part. In higher part of the house, it fall on doctor's shoulder. The snake coiled round doctor's left arm above the elbow. The snake was, as you know, coiled in the left hand of the doctor. The snake's wood was only there 3 to 4 inches away from the doctor's face. Snake's hood, as you know, upper part, only 3-4 inches far away from the doctor's face. What type of situation you can imagine? The doctor turned absolutely still in the face of danger so close by, and he just thought only 3-4 inches away from his face. He prayed to God and then realized that he was foolish and stupid doctor, as he did not have any medicine for snake bite with him. He thought about the medicine, that he was foolish doctor, that he doesn't keep this type of snake bite medicine. Thus he would surely die if the snake bit him. If the snake bit him, he would surely die. He had that type of fear, he had that type of thinking, and thought himself to be a foolish, thinking like this, that he would surely die if the snake bit him. Then doctors escape from the snake. Next point, doctors escape from the snake. When the snake turned its hood, it saw its reflection in the mirror on the table. When the snake turned its hood, It was its reflection in the mirror of the table. Naturally, the doctor was sitting on a chair in front of the mirror. And snake fell on his shoulder. When the snake saw towards the mirror, it saw its reflection. The snake unwound, freed itself from the doctor's arm and crept over to the table to have a close look at itself. So that he released from the doctor's arm itself, leaving doctor's arm, freed doctor's arm, and it started seeing towards mirror its own reflection. The doctor thus got an opportunity to escape from the house. In this way, you know, the doctor got an opportunity to escape, to run away from the house. He ran every fear. He ran very fast and went to the friend's house. Immediately, without thinking much, he just, as soon as the snake freed his arms and went toward the mirror to see its own face, the doctor got a chance to escape from the house. He ran very fast and went to friend's house. After bathing there, he spent the night at the friend's place. He took bath and he spent night there. That shows that he had lot of fear and he escaped from this house. Next page. Doctor shipped from the house. Doctor shipped, changed his house. See, the next morning the narrator went to his room with his friend. The next morning the narrator went to his room with his friend as he had decided to vacate the house immediately. He didn't want to live there. He wanted to go to another place. So he decided to vacate the house, make it empty immediately. He went to collect his belongings, his things. However, he found that some thieves had stolen most of his belongings, leaving behind only one of the doctor's dirty vests. Then he realized when he went to his house that thieves had stolen most of his belongings, things. And that is why telling that he just, because he ran away, as you know, without lock the house. And that is why when he went to early in the morning with his friend to vacate the house, there was nothing, because most of the all the things, belongings had been stolen. Only the one dirty vest only there, nothing else. See now chapter highlights. The narrator and his friend are listening to a story being told by homeopathic doctor about his encounter with a snake. The narrator and his friend are listening to a story being told by homeopathic doctor about his encounter with a snake. Point number two. The doctor tells that this happened on a hot summer night when, after having dinner at a restaurant, he had returned to his house. His room was shared by lots of rats who lived in tiled roof. The tiled roof was there, so naturally he found many rats in his house. That is second point. Again, that the doctor tells that this happened on a hot summer night when, after having dinner at a restaurant, he returned to his house. His room was shared by lots of rats who lived in tiled roof. Many rats were there in tiled room. Point number 3. When he sat down at the table to read, he looked in the mirror there and decided that he would shave daily. He sat in front of the mirror on a chair, observing his face. He thought, he decided to shave daily, grow a thin mustache, and would always smile, all for looking more handsome. According to him, these three things are necessary to look handsome. Number 1, shave daily. Number 2, keep thin mustache. And number 3, keep smiling face. After all, he was a young bachelor. He also thought of marriage to a fat woman doctor who would have medical practice and lots of money. He decided to marry a lady doctor, marry a woman who was fat and lot of money and also doing practice. Number 4, point number, suddenly a snake fell down on his shoulder. Suddenly a snake fell down on his shoulder, coiling round his left arm with his hood less than 4 inches from the doctor's face. Less than 3 or 4 inches, its hood remained far away from the doctor's face. He saw that it was a cobra, and the snake was, as you know, very poisonous cobra. So naturally he had that type of fear. But the snake coiled in his left arm. Now it was difficult to escape immediately for the doctor also. Point number 5. The doctor did not move but started praying to God, because he realized that he did not have any medicine for snake bite. The doctor did not move, sit in same situation, but started praying to God because he realized that he did not have any medicine for snake bite. He thought of himself as a stupid doctor. He thought himself to be a stupid doctor, that he did not keep the medicine. Point number 6. The snake turned and saw its own reflection in the mirror on the table. It uncoiled itself from the doctor's arm. It uncoiled itself from the doctor's arm to move closer to the mirror, maybe appreciate its own beauty. It also sees its face, its hood in the mirror, and it itself released, escape, or in other words, uncoiled itself from the doctor's arm and went near, close to the mirror. Point number 7. The doctor got a chance to run away from the room. He stayed the rest of the night at a friend's room. He went and reached to his friend's house. He got a chance to escape, and that is why he went away. He got a chance, he used it, ran very fast and went to his friend's house and passed night there. Number 8. Deciding to vacate his room immediately, next morning the doctor returned to his room with his friend to collect his belongings. Next morning he went to house to vacate the house with his friend. However, he found that a thief had stolen all of his belongings except of a dirty vest. When he reached his home, he realized that most of his belongings were stolen. Thief had stolen this because he ran away without locking the door, without locking the house. That is why he realized that his belongings, the things, were stolen. Point number 10, the doctor ended his story by saying that he never again saw the snake that was fascinated by its own beauty. The doctor ended his story by saying that he never again saw the snake that was fascinated by its own beauty. The doctor told, then he never see that particular doctor, that particular snake, he never saw again. That shows that what he observed, what he did, that he must think about it. Now the word meaning. That we will see next. We are seeing today word meaning. See, the given page number correspondent to the pages in the prescribed textbook. See, on page number 56, electrified, having electric connection. Major, small in quantity, less, not so white, dirty. Tiled means having tiles, that is called tile. See on right side, gables means upper part of walls, below a sloping, that is called gables. Ceiling, inside room of the room, that is called ceiling. Traffic, as you know, movement here. Wind god seemed to have taken time off. There was no bridge. Tempted means have an urge. Admire, person who looks with pleasure. Make me presence felt. Have an noticeable effect. Parting, lean on the head, made by combining sideways. Earth shaking, important. Earth shaking in the sense important. Past means walk. Resumed, went back to. Third, sound of something heavy falling. That is third. Page number 58, wriggled. Twisted or turned quickly. Landed means dropped. Slithered, moved with a twisting motion. That is called slithered. Merely, merely means just. Holding my breath without breathing. Turned to stone. Totally still, remain in same situation. The creator of this world and his universe means, in this universe means God. Laden, heavy metal. Made of molten fire means burning hot, too much. Drain of all strength, feeling weak. Lark, waited in hiding and it stuck. The snake bit, that is called it stuck. Page number 59, you see, vermilion spot, orange spot put on center of the woman, at closer quarters from nearer, next not mere image cut in granite, no longer still, while otherwise wanted something different, life companion means wife. Life companion means ready means tall, ready means tall. The gift of sprinter, quickly running ability. Page number 60, smeared means spread, removed, stolen, clean out, removed of belonging, rascal means mischievous persons, taken with means attacked by. These are the meanings. If you prepare the meanings and you realize, you learn in a proper way and you can understand the lesson easily. Keep till here and brings the end of this lecture. Next lecture, thinking about the text we will see of this particular lesson. Write this one time in your book and read 3 times. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye.